Hi, my name is Athanasios Kolios, and I'm a professor in Risk and Asset Integrity Management at the University of Strathclyde. I'm also leading Work Package 8 of the ROMEO Project, which has developed an integrated life cycle impact assessment tool, as you will see in the following slides. Work Package 8 aims to support the overall project through an integrated comparative assessment of the key elements of impact, namely components of cost, life cycle attributes and associated environmental factors. The work package will focus on the impact of the findings of the other work packages by comparing offshore wind cases before implementations of the outcomes of the project and after. A central pillar is on how these translate to reduce project risk and O&M costs through reduction of uncertainty and lifetime extension, leading to improved reliability, thereby increasing the impact. Here, we can see the objectives and structure of the work package. So far, three publicly available deliverables have been produced. One, presenting a review of existing cost and O&M support models. A second one, accounting for provisions of environmental impact assessment of the operation of offshore wind farms, including a detailed inventory of components, materials, and processes. And finally, the third deliverable, which documents the development of our own impact assessment module. From the beginning, we have defined a number of elements that the tool under development should incorporate, extending functionalities of existing tools and applying modeling of sufficient fidelity to allow for the impact assessment of the innovations of the ROMEO project. More specifically, the tool should be modular, with the individual steps having clearly defined interfaces. Users should be able to enter their input values manually or through parametric equations, and where required, new parametric equations should be developed based on existing data. The different phases of the service life of the asset should be mapped in sufficient detail, and this is high fidelity, so as to account for the impact of sensitive parameters. Operation and maintenance costs should be calculated in detail and utilizing latest reliability data through appropriate engineering models. Uncertainties of key variables should be considered in a systematic way, assigning confidence levels on the expressions of estimated KPIs. And finally, the environmental impact throughout the service life of the asset should be assessed based on modern unit emission databases. Within the tool, it is important to account for the impact of O&M decisions throughout the service life of the assets, as certain decisions will affect CapEx and others will provide valuable input for their end-of-life scenarios. This constitutes our model as a real life cycle impact assessment, which can provide meaningful input to relevant decisions. Our tool comprises of five individual modules, namely the general site characteristics module, detailing the weather conditions, site water depth, distance from port, vessel, cost of personnel, etc. Then we have the CapEx module, consisting of the development and consenting, production and acquisition, installation and commissioning, and development and disposal phases of the offshore wind farm. We have the OPEX or the O&M module, which incorporates data from the operational phase of the offshore wind farm. We have the FINEX module with parameters on financing expenditures, such as the weighted average cost of capital, inflation rate, equity and debt to debt ratio. And finally, the environmental impact assessment module, which translates quantities of materials and types of processes to emissions-related KPIs. Each of the modules includes a number of sub-modules which allow external tools to be integrated in the analysis. Now, the O&M module is the core of the impact assessment tool, as it allows time domain simulations to be performed, simulating the reliability performance of the asset throughout its service life. The main modules are the reliability module, the weather forecasting module, and the maintenance module. The reliability module is further divided into the mean time to failure, namely the uptime of the asset estimation, and the mean time to repair estimation throughout the maintenance operations. The mean time to repair calculation is based on the annual failure rates, while the maintenance operations, both planned and unplanned, require data related to the resources required for the repairs. The time to repair is calculated in the maintenance main module and is used as input in the reliability module. Resulting downtime depends on the availability of the required vessels, the technicians, the weather windows, spare parts, mission operating times, duration of navigation and repair, as well as the required number of technicians shifts. The weather modeling module enables the forecasting of the future sea states, namely future significant wave heights and wind speeds. Weather conditions play an important role in the total downtime of the wind farm, as when the relayed parameters surpass the set wave height and wind speed limits of the vessels, traveling to wind turbines and accessing them becomes impossible. Therefore, unfavorable weather conditions will delay repairs, thus increasing downtime and decreasing the wind farm's availability. Further, weather conditions also affect power production. The maintenance module covers planned and unplanned maintenance activities and take into account the actual duration of all stages required to perform the repair and maintenance operations and use vessels and crew day rates, along with material costs to estimate the total O&M costs. Other outputs of the module the model are the time-based and production-based availability and the power production losses. Considering that offshore wind is a sustainable energy technology, we need to ensure that the asset's life cycle emissions are estimated and reduced so as to increase the effectiveness of the technology in terms of environmental footprint. More specifically, a number of considerations were found while reviewing available literature and have been incorporated into the tool developed. Firstly, the manufacturing stage usually comprises of all raw materials, energy and transportation required for the main and secondary components of the structure and the infrastructure in the case of wind farm. The installation stage takes into account the transportation and the energy consumption required for the on-site installation. Distances between assembly and erection point are site-dependent for both onshore and offshore applications. The operation and maintenance stage includes all the routine inspections and preventive or corrective maintenance requirements in terms of energy, materials, and transportation for ensuring the efficient operation of the equipment. Replacement in some components may be included. Finally, the end-of-life stage includes the decommissioning and the final disposal of the wind turbines. Recycling is a beneficial practice regarding the total environmental impact of the life cycle of a wind turbine or a farm. It should also be noted that a number of input variables for the life cycle calculations are subject to extensive uncertainties. To this end, the model has been extended to account for stochastic inputs which can systematically capture the effect of these uncertainties to the calculated KPIs. Following this logic and adopting a Monte Carlo simulations approach, the terminology migrates from the conventional deterministic inputs to deterministic outputs approach to accepting a series of statistical distribution as inputs which result to an expression of selected KPIs as a joint probability density function. As a result, the outcomes are expressed as values with an associated confidence level. The tool, as we can see in this slide, requests a number of inputs for each of its individual modules in order to be able to calculate the variation of the values of KPIs as a result of the alternative O&M strategies that will be tested. Based on consultation between the ROMEO partners, which offer a comprehensive representation of the offshore wind supply chain, a number of impact assessment scenarios and relevant key performance indicators have qualified. Looking into KPIs, the tool can calculate values for wind turbine availability, wind farm availability, maintenance costs, OPEX, LCOE, net present value, revenue loss, downtime, duration of offshore operations and environmental impact, among others, offering visualization of results through various different ways. To give you an idea of the types of outputs, here we can see the breakdown of life cycle costs based on the different phases of a project's development, as well as a sensitivity analysis of key input variables, illustrating the ones having higher impact to the KPIs of interest, which in this case was selected to be the value, the net present value. And here we can see presentation of values for different KPIs expressed in stochastic terms. These probability density functions for LCOE, OPEX, and CAPEX for a hypothetical case allow for evaluation of the probability that certain thresholds will be exceeded in presence of uncertain inputs. The O&M module can return values for availability, downtime breakdown, energy produced, cost breakdown, revenue produced, as well as detailed values of different O&M activities that are anticipated based on the failure rates that are fed into the system. The breakdown of downtime is also valuable as it can allow for optimization of the operational readiness of an organization. It should be noted that each of the main modules and several of the sub-modules of the tool can also run individually and can be integrated to other tools. Here we have, as an example, an illustration of a graphical user interface of the power module. The fully parametric and modular nature of the tool has allowed us to perform targeted research to a number of interesting topics that increase the fidelity of the tool and further enhance the existing body of knowledge. To this end, we have developed advanced approaches to weather forecasting and compared them to existing ones, aiming to increase accuracy and reduce computational time, as time domain simulations can be computationally resource intensive. As a result, we have developed a hybrid probabilistic method which can achieve these objectives, performing better than the conventional Markov chains approach, which is included in many of the existing similar solutions. In addition, we have managed to quantify the effect of early warnings through more capable condition monitoring systems through the PF module we have developed and incorporated into our model. This has been an important step which will allow us to run further scenarios to quantify the benefits that this project has achieved. To sum up, this activity has developed a high-fidelity lifecycle cost-revenue model for offshore wind farms, taking into account the most recent cost estimates. The tool includes four functionalities, which distinguish it from what is available in literature and commercial applications and allows for a more well-informed assessment of lifecycle cost. Namely, the consideration of costs and revenues and actual time that transactions occur, a high-fidelity O&M tool to allow for flexible consideration of variation of maintenance strategies, stochastic consideration of relevant inputs to allow for confidence levels to be assigned to the various KPIs that will be considered, and finally, the environmental impact of O&M-related activities are estimated through appropriate parametric relationships. The developed tool allows for the evaluation of the impact of the innovations of the ROMEO project based on different KPIs. I would like to thank you very much for watching, and I would welcome any comment or suggestion on this activity.